Okie dokie, gentlemen, are we all here ready to fucking go? I asked y'all a question!
As I reveal my giant monkey!
That's not as funny as you thought it was, boy!
God, I thought it meant penis!
I swear, the only thing I hate more than weaklings...
Hey! I'm speaking, soldier! Don't fucking speak unless you're smart to fucking nerd! What we're gonna do is we're gonna fly over the bird.
The talk show at the end of the week.
Space is big.
Star Citizen.
There's a free hot dog that I found on the floor.
It's really big.
Round table.
Right. Okay. Welcome to the roundtable. We're back. It's Sunday. Without any of us.
No, he's got real world things to deal with.
How dare he?
How dare he?
Well, it is Father's Day here.
No.
That's a bunch of...
What?
Talking to the devil.
They were just bashing you hardcore, too.
Were you listening?
How dare you?
I was just listening to the beginning of the show to see what you guys were going to say about me, fuckers.
Oh, so are you still going to leave?
No. Actually, my plans got canceled.
Wow.
Funny story. I left my lights on when I got home on Friday. And then so my battery is dead. And I got a jump, but I guess you can't. New cars, the alternators, they don't charge. They just maintain. So I didn't have enough cranking power to be able to go anywhere.
Oh, your car. You
because know. It wouldn't start because apparently they don't charge the batteries anymore, which I find kind of stupid. Not so sure it's true.
I don't blame that.
Neither do I, but I was I'm not going to sit around and risk it. So I just canceled all my plans. The Conservative, thank you very much for 2 months. Yes, we're still doing it, as unbelievable as it seems. We are still doing it. I was able to come back to the show.
Yay!
Yippee!
Not to say that I'm going to have much to offer. This is a pretty shitty week.
Well, no, actually, there's been a few interesting things of recent.
Yeah, I've got some good news.
Go on, what's that?
My stuff is back.
Your stuff is back.
My stuff is back. See, I have stuff.
Tell me the story.
It was the first time I logged into 3.19.1. I don't even know. So it launched. It went to publish to live without any downtime. Right? They were bragging about that fact, like, oh, we launched 3.19.1 to the live service without any downtime. Right? That's some sort of feat for them. But I hadn't logged in before. So I didn't really know what was going on anyway. I just updated and went into the game. And I spawned at... I picked the home location, Orson, and it was just... There was nothing there. Not anything in the inventory. It was completely empty. I did have my ships, though, because I went to the spaceport. The fleet manager had all the ships that I owned right there, just as you can see here. All the inventory, stowage space, everything was gone. Knickknacks didn't report anything being anywhere in any of the spaceports either. So this was all empty. Completely empty. Apart from the standard suit that you get as a noob suit, you know, with a pistol. But there, I looked around. Doesn't look like many people had this issue. But what I did see are a bunch of people that did report it on the issue council. Holy crap, my... And, yeah, so people like patch wiped all inventories. 7 contributions, not a lot. But then there was someone who pointed out there's another issue. Missing ships and pledge items after 3.19.1 update. 324 contributions. But these were mostly people who also apparently lost access to all of their ships. Which was not the case for me, but I guess it's still a variant of whatever happened. I don't know what happened. But just funnily enough, just now, like 15 minutes ago, I logged in and I was like just for the sake of it, see if anything changed. And everything was back. And I was like, huh. It took a while to get from the servers. Well, I don't know what happened. They either did something. The CIG did something to already remedy the issue, which is also maybe possible that because I did a character repair yesterday, even though after the repair I logged in and I still didn't have any of my stuff, it may still have triggered something in the persistency storage with my character making it come back after maybe a couple hours or something. Because this is just now was the first time I logged in after that and I had all my stuff back. So it really is no telling. But
so I'm going to contribute to this. So yesterday my game crashed while I was in my Defender with my brand new
Wanderer. Say it isn't so.
My Wanderer paint. And it crashed. And so I tried to get back in quickly, but obviously they didn't bring me back to my ship. And I woke up at the space station and I reclaimed my Defender, but my paint vanished. My brand new paint only used it once.
Was it quit on the ship?
And now I'm checking. It was quit on the ship. So now I'm checking again and now it's back. So it's possible that CIG did do something in the back end. There was an issue with the inventory with the 0.1 patch. A lot of people have been complaining about it.
Yeah.
Various different issues from random stuff just not being in their inventory to like yours, which was completely gone altogether. So they're quite obviously aware of it, and it's possible that they might be doing something in the back end.
It's nice that way, at least, that they can fiddle with this without it having to take down anything like downtimes.
Oh yeah.
They've really improved, at least compared to a couple of years ago. Maybe this is like they can do a lot more stuff without having to intervene with the rest of the players and the uptime of the game servers, which previously was all tied together so much that they had to do a reset. They had to reset everything and they had to restart all the servers, and now it's just persistency is so disconnected from the rest. It is connected, but it's like, yeah, separate, and it can be maintained separately, can be repaired without interfering so much. It's kind of interesting.
Now, I still didn't get the ship that I bought in the game. They still are just vanished. Maybe that's a...
I hadn't bought any ship in the game. What did happen, though, is that all the looted items were brought to my home location too after the patch.
Yes, I did that. I remember the stuff that I got in Po'olisar, I immediately brought to my home, which is normally in New Babbage, to see would it transfer over to point one, and it did. Now, they did say that they were trying to get that to work, and it looks like it did work. Now, the rest of the stuff that I had elsewhere has vanished. I did have stuff
executive
at Everest Harbor. But yeah, regarding ships, people are complaining more about ships that they earned in game, and they still haven't got that back yet, I think. Well, I haven't got it back.
Is that more incentive to buy the ships instead of getting them in game?
Not really. I think that no, I disagree. I think there's a lot more people.
I'm being sarcastic.
Oh, sorry. Okay. Your tone wasn't sarcastic enough. You have to work on that. There's Junta.
Like, I got three of these executive custodians. It's funny. Executive Devastator Shotgun.
Oh, yeah, okay. They still haven't fixed the paint.
No, four
on them,
though. Actually. There's a one, two, three, four.
Yeah, you can give me one of them, then.
I wonder if they're still this common in the loot tables in this patch.
Well, that was the rarest gun in the game at one time.
Uh-huh. Technically, it's not even... It's still only a lootable version, right? Because the Custodian Executive Edition was never handed out to Concierge members.
No.
Even though the executive branding would mean it's for Concierge members, like the sniper rifle was, and the suit was as well.
The only ones who were seen to use it were Debs. They used to go around showing it off.
Yeah.
Particularly in the Evo Caddy, we've seen them use that. But yeah, they seem to throw nearly everything down the loot table.
Yeah.
Which, I don't know if you've seen it, the new Xeno threat stuff now are also now in the loot table.
Yeah.
What Xeno threat stuff?
So, Xeno threat armor.
Modified armor pieces.
Go to the wiki Discord.
Oh, you mean the ones that you would only get if you got the reputation?
No, these are actually for the faction members themselves, I think. Just like Ninetales modified armor sets are for Ninetales members or NPCs wearing them. I'm assuming these Xenothread armor pieces will be worn by NPCs from Xenothread. Where is that?
It should be... Where is it?
Yeah, the tiny images. Yeah. They have a tiny logo. It's weird that they had different versions seen, right?
Yeah, there's one with a huge logo, oversized, and then there's another one with this tiny one.
That may have been wrong or something.
The oversized, that one looks wrong. For an orc like them, you would think that they would be bragging, so they would have an oversized kind of logo that looks like it was sprayed on, like a stencil kind of thing. It's a variant of the Orc Mark 10 core suit. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Looks kind of neat.
Yeah, I think it's cool. Definitely looks better than the original. I like the extra bits that I have on. So this is what I like about CIG, reusing assets and just tinkering with it and making it slightly different. I would like to see more of that with the other gear, particularly like weapons as well. That you might see some custom things, you know, added onto it.
Well, what's interesting is go back to the the thing that says the statistics on it, where it was saying it was modified.
Yeah,
yeah. All the Ninetale armor pieces have that same text at the end of it.
I'm wondering if that what does it say in regards to the modifications and stuff like that, because remember they did say that eventually there'll be the ability for the players to modify stuff, so I'm curious as to what does it say for the modification.
It's usually the exact same stats. That's exactly the same stat as the original Mark 10, Mark X, so...
Just skin modified, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I hope there is a modification that will make it special. So therefore it's worth having or worth selling, kind of thing.
Yeah, maybe they just haven't put it in yet.
No, I doubt we'll be seeing that for a while.
So the Vanduul are playing around with the Ninetales now?
Maybe.
Bastards.
Get ready.
What else we got going on? You guys said that there was a lot of good news.
I'm trying to keep the good stuff for the end.
Okay, we're at the end.
Oh, we're at the end.
So what Let's start towards the beginning of the week. Inside Star Citizen.
Well, that's more towards the end, really. But
is that really towards the end? Oh, okay.
No.
I thought that was going to be our filler. You had some better news.
No. We always start off with Inside Star Citizen anyway. Go on. So, did you watch it?
Yes, I just forgot what it was about. Remind me.
It's great being old. Yes, I love it. Oh, the Santa Kia. Yes.
Yeah.
Got me brain.
And the whole sea. Yeah.
And the whole sea. God, how see? This is all ahead of you, kids. I swear, your brain just switches off. Yeah. So. Santa Kiai, I got this, and now I love it even more. It's basically the Hornet version of the Cartwheel, if you can call it that. Mm-hmm. It's kind of a medium to heavy fighter. They don't have the original or the guns that's supposed to come with it. You're supposed to get the four Xion special guns.
Those are just badgers.
So it probably won't be as OP as it should be. I think it looks really cool.
That's why we need to go to Pyro, because you know, remember that guy who had the Vanduul guns and stuff? You know, he might have the guns that we need for that thing.
He's supposed to have everything at a price. So the first thing I notice is that two of the LA devs are now in Austin. That's the first thing I noticed in this segment.
Did they say they were in
track of them?
No. Well, they look like they're in Austin. That's the Austin office.
An office is an office, dude.
that's Austin.
Well, that one does look like Austin, but I thought he was. Is it Austin?
I recognize that floor anywhere. I thought it was the most hideous floor ever.
Maybe they just moved the floor to. It's like you can have this shit.
Now you can tell by the background as well.
Yeah,
I will say that it
Texas
does look
plants.
Like he might
Texas
be, maybe he's
climate.
Just visiting.
Eventually, the LA office is going to close. They're
no,
gonna
I
move.
Don't. I don't
think so.
Do you
understand the state of California right now?
But do they not get tax breaks there in Austin? That's the reason why they're there.
They have
tax breaks in Austin. They don't get tax breaks in California. They get tax penalties for everything you do.
Yeah,
it's just as close to the movie industry, so therefore they can.
Yeah,
tap
but
in.
They don't really need to be near the movie industry anymore. They got all the celebs and all that other shit.
All those people come to Britain now, to the UK.
That's true too.
Manchester.
Right? That's true.
Well, yeah. See, UK also is a great theater.
Yes.
Center, so it's easy to get top talent at cheap cost.
Most of the, well, I don't want to say most, but a lot of the best actors that play American roles are British, just speak with an American accent.
Yeah, you just send them to a coach, you know, and after a week they'd be speaking American, basically.
Speaking American.
American, yeah.
Yeah, boy.
Speaking American. I was going to say something about that. So yeah, it's a good cheap way to get good talent, I think that's the reason why you're also stay in LA. LA has something kind of similar. There's still a lot of good talent there, and it's a good center place to get anything to do with the movie industry. And I think this game is more closer to movies than any other, really, if you think about it. Especially with Squadron. But yeah, so surprised to see those two in Austin. I wonder, did they either relocate there or?
I think you're still jumping to conclusions a little bit.
I probably am. I'd like to stare
because he was working on the Santa Kia. He had to be there with maybe another vehicle team.
We saw Chris. What's his name? The other artist.
Oh, my fridge is gone.
The other artist, Chris Smith.
Chris Smith. So he was there in the background when they were doing that interview.
And he's in Austin.
So he's in Austin. So maybe they were visiting for a meeting. Not that one. The other guy. Um, There's Crispin in the background.
Oh yeah.
And you can see him working on the storm tank.
Oh, but yeah, leaks.
That's not much of a leak. We know that they're working on it.
Yeah. So they were explaining that
it failed
Greybox.
So they failed miserably.
Yeah, and some of the community laughed at you. God damn it. But I prefer it to fail than giving us a mediocre
part of the development process, and people are upset about it.
Well, no. What happened was they weren't ready. They tried to get through before they were done with everything that they needed to have, and they said, nope, you're not moving forward until you get that part done. So, which is just a HUD.
And who does that review process? Isn't it that Chris and some other?
Well, it's a bunch of people, I'm sure. But it's just a HUD. I was going to say it's just a HUD, but the HUD is actually one of the more intricate parts of the ship that they really got to nail down and have right. And they did say that it's going to be the standard template for all of the Apoa ships, including the scout that they need to apply it to as well. So they just said, nope, you got to get that done before you can move on. So.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the phone is ringing.
Yeah, and I think Jared showed a very bad image of it, of the new HUD they were talking about. I don't think it's even worth putting up. He had it on Twitter. But yeah, I like the way it unfolds and all that. Looks cool. Slightly disappointed in no Geon guns again, but yeah.
She's just not ready.
Just not ready. Yeah, I think they were hoping to get it ready for the Alien Week event. Some people are asking, though, is it worth it? It's quite an expensive alien ship. There's a classic alien tax to it. I think it's, what, $275?
Alien tax.
A lot more expensive than a Hornet.
And it's floating.
Well, the legs are not out on that one. There is supposed to be legs.
Is there?
Yeah.
Because he did mention the hover tech.
Well, yeah, there is the Geon hover tech, but no, the legs do pop out. It's probably another element that wasn't ready at the time when they did this. I think we do see it in the green version. You can see the legs pop out. There, see it there.
Oh yeah, claws. Finding claws. Little pincers.
But they could have changed that and made a hover. Won't be surprised.
She is pretty.
Yeah, I can't wait for the actual skin to be on it. That's just a simple plain one. See, if you ever look at the Cartwell close up, it has a really nice pattern to it. It looks kind of like an alien version of carbon fiber. You know, the pattern that you get in carbon fiber.
Mm-hmm.
So I hope they have that kind of detailing to it. And then I can't wait to fly it to see, is that a worthy fighter or not?
The one guy was saying that because of the way they did the Fury and that the engines can like turn 180 and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. He was trying to see if he can replicate that with that ship as well and make it more maneuverable and stuff like that. He said he was trying to push it to its limits. So I will be curious to see what kind of maneuverability that thing has.
Well, the Cartuel was supposed to have that. The Cartuel was supposed to be designed to be a very nippy, zippy.
I'm sure they'll go back and
and
apply some of that old newer tech to it.
Yeah, so they did show that. That came out really nice. Look forward to. But really, the even though they named the show after the Santa Kai, the real stealer of the show was the Hull C.
Yes.
Yeah. So I'm really excited. I actually genuinely got my hair stood up on my arm when I saw it, because this is the ship that I pledged for, really, all the way back. It is slightly larger than the original one, the original Hull C, but still, yeah.
There's tractor beam.
It is. There's four tractor beams on it. One here, one underneath it. And then there's two more on the front atop a bomb. And you'll need a remote operator to control these. So if you're thinking doing this single-handedly on your own, good luck.
No way.
If they're working by the time they release the ship.
Well, I think.
Well, remember, they said that they have that hack in place for loading and unloading the ship.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't require tractor beams.
Why do you think you need more than one person?
Ships don't, Jesus Christ.
Ships don't sink just because you get out of the pilot seat.
Is that part of an 890 jump?
It's a part of an 890 jump.
Somebody crashed
looks
an 890
like the two
jump.
Parts.
Well, he probably went into the rings, yeah.
And went boom.
Boom, yeah. So strongly advised to EVA. Was that a box? I think that was a box beside you.
I was just going to land in this. No, it's someone in a broken...
Oh, it's a player. No, no, sorry. It's a,
that's a little naked body.
Already been straight naked, yeah. I didn't do it, by the way.
No.
No, that wasn't me.
Is that a dead body moving around, or is that...
No, it's floating. Bad...
Yeah, you're missing your opportunities here, You should be salvaging all of that crap.
I'm in the middle of trying to do paints. The alien paints.
A part of a Gladius.
So, I'm trying to get them up in the wiki for Alien Week. It's a lot slower. Cartuel is a pain in the butt to do it because there's a bug with the lighting on it, so it doesn't appear properly, so you have to do twice as many pictures to get it done.
So you're taking pictures that are offering you absolutely no money in game versus actually salvaging, which will give you money in game.
It doesn't matter. I can do this at any time, and I'll
that's a gear up.
That's a Crusader.
Avenger, yeah.
There's always Avenger about, yeah.
Well, it looked like it was missing its front end.
Oh, it was a wreck for sure. Oop, don't crash into him.
But I guarantee there's a few bodies about for looting and a few boxes. There's always stuff about. So if you ever want to gear up quickly, go to Paolo, sir.
You see, this is why they need to just blow it up and get it away, because it's a safety hazard. It's a safety hazard to all people.
Unqualified pilots are going around in stupidly large ships.
This is what you get when you open space travel to commercial idiots.
We need to have certification put in place here.
It'll be like that in the future too. People leaving junk everywhere.
Need a license.
Like on Earth.
Wow. So
let's talk about the whole siege.
Yeah, I was going to go the footage.
Let him store his ship.
That's where I store my ship. Can't just exit the game like that.
Sure you can.
So, look at it. Look at the folding. Beautiful. So this, been working on this 6-7 years, really. It's been a while, but the way it folds up is just fantastically beautiful. You can see other wonderful things, like there's a window there. You can see the window at the back of the front section.
Yeah.
So you can actually look out and it. That's cool.
Oh yeah.
And they finally figured out how to work, allowing you to go through the central section even when it's folding or unfolding. That's cool.
Don't do it. It's a trap. No, Silent wants to get back into the game. I'm telling him it's a trap.
It's a trap.
It's 100% a trap.
I love what they've done with the sea. I like the fact that they actually showed you what it means to be a stupid person in trying to dock the thing with cargo. Although I guarantee you people are going to do it anyway.
That's how sexual that is.
And it's cool that when it's not fully laded or doesn't have its arms extracted, that you can just land it in a large hangar.
Yes. Yeah.
But yeah, that is so freaking cool.
Oh, that's cool. This is cool.
Yeah.
You can stand in the tube when this happens.
It took a while, but yeah, it's great to see. They kept the proportions similar to what the original design was. There was a previous version than this, and it looked weird. The front section was slightly longer, and it just didn't look right compared to the original concept. So Chris obviously turned around and said, "No, try again." And all he did was cleverly they flipped the cargo pads around, so they were back to each other, and it just made the front section slightly fatter but shorter. And it just looks really cool.
I think it looks great, just collapsed and stuff like that. I mean, it's almost like I feel like it's a bigger version of a Freelancer.
A lot bigger than
it's like a really big Freelancer, when it doesn't have the arms extended and it's closed up.
This is funny.
Yep.
This is the who was it again? We saw in ISC a while ago, having fun with the engine to try and make this footage.
Yeah.
Like boom, and this.
Oh yeah, I guarantee players will be trying to do that. That'll be very expensive. That's a lot of cargo. Yep. So people pointed out that when they were showing off the stats, it was like 9,000 FCU or something like that. But that was a bug. It's only 4,068, I think.
Cylon, to answer your question, no, it's not that bad. I mean, it has its moments. Obviously, when they release a patch, usually the performance is horrible until they get it all fixed and everything. But once they get it stable and playable again, it's enjoyable. It can be enjoyable. Depends on what it is that you're trying to do.
Yeah, no, they're definitely progressing nicely. It is frustrating with the bugs. Don't get me wrong. 318 and beginning of 319 haven't been great, but still it's definitely, you can see the progress, and it's getting better. There's no doubt about that. You can have fun. The best thing to do is have fun with others. I I've always recommended that. But mining is great and salvaging is fun as well.
You know, it's really interesting. I wanted to bring this up, and I guess this could be a decent segue. The commercials that they do on YouTube, it's like they are pitching it as a playable game until like the very last splash screen where they say it's in active development.
Are they cunning us?
Yeah, but this is the, this is the whole debate about This is a whole argument with the fact that everything on the Pledge store is no longer really a crowdfunding donation anymore. At this point, I think it was, you could almost argue, was already years and years ago that was no longer really legally the case. And they may still. I don't know what actually legally the case is, but it does kind of just feel like that everything you buy on the Pledge store is just a purchase. It's no longer really a donation.
I disagree because really, it's actually more of a donation now than it was before, and I'll tell you why. Because almost everything is purchasable in game. With the exception of obviously the ships that aren't freaking built yet. And so they don't have to buy them.
Yep.
They don't.
Exactly. Yeah. And they more players are doing that.
They're in the game. You don't have to buy it. You already, if you already have the game, you're in. Right? So it's really, I really do think that it's becoming more of a donation now than before. Now, that's if you want to look at it from that kind of a perspective. The other perspective is, I don't want to go, you know, now that I'm playing it and I get all the bugs and I lose everything and they're doing the wipes and everything, I have to go do it again. It's going to drive people to want to buy the real thing so that they don't have to go through that shit over and over and over again.
So it's even more of a scam.
Yeah,
so
it's
even more of a scam.
Purposefully giving you a bad game. So
it also just brings into question all the ship prices that we have, because if everything was a donation, truly a donation, then technically all the ships could have the same price, because a donation for a digital good in a virtual world doesn't really have any difference in price other than maybe development costs. But you're not buying a ship, you're donating money. So, I mean, the ship, everything else just acts like it's an actual purchase. You're buying a ship because some ships are more expensive than others. Everything has a different price, and you're getting something digitally in exchange for money, i.e. your purchase. But whatever, it's like semantics there are really vague. I don't really see it like donations anymore. But then again, you're just funding a game's development, just like any other early access project on Steam, really, which Richard also purchases. I think they're not really donations. They've never been donations, I think. Only really Kickstarter campaigns are donations, right?
No, they still sit well.
And then again, Kickstarter has a failsafe too, that when it doesn't reach their goal, people get refunded their money.
Well, you're looking for your money back now?
No.
Huh? You non-believer?
I didn't
now?
Say that.
Good God, man. What's happened to you?
He's more experienced, and now he's thinking, okay, I shouldn't have bought this. I should have just bought that, and now I kind of want to get a refund for this because I didn't really need it. I only wanted that.
Yeah, that okay, actually so does a lot.
That's more like
what someone
he's
that's fair
company. He's like, yeah. So let's talk about the whole sea cargo thing, right? So it supposedly it recognizes if your ship is collapsed, so it won't put any cargo on there. And then apparently you have to actually go into it, looked like, you know, like the hollow squares to let you know, hey, you need to go into this area.
Well, that's the docking position
to populate the stuff on your ship.
Yeah.
docking with a station.
Yeah, you seem to have to go to a different area. I'm guessing you have to line within the box, and therefore the cargo then will load. I'm not sure. Do you do it while docked or not?
Well, I guess it's hard to, they didn't clarify that because if you have your stuff open.
This looked like it was undocked. If
you're docked to the thing there, like you see right now, mm-hmm. you would think it would just populate it on it there.
Yeah.
Right. Versus having to actually go to the little holographic squares have it fill in.
My theory is that to go to this other area, because this is where you'll eventually have to move the boxes by tractor beam.
Yeah, that makes sense. Just laying the groundwork for the future tech and stuff.
The actual cargo section of the station.
Yeah, exactly.
Which is a different irregular docking things.
So that will be fun in the future, because if you don't know, all the boxes will have to be moved manually, either by the dockers of the station or by yourself. The dockers, you'll have to pay them, so that's a money sink, or you can do it yourself, and it'll probably take longer, but you do save money. So that will be an interesting thing in the future. But in the meantime, I'm guessing you just go to a kind of a parking area and they just magically appear, as you see here. But the good thing about this is that now, I think they left out in this video. It was on the YouTube one where they had a comedy section where they tried to land the whole sea.
Underground.
On the ground. Yeah, no, I think whoever did this video left it out. So you had to try to land, and it can tell that, well, you can't land because you're fully extended. You have to collapse. So if you're extended, it will give you a docking ring. If you're collapsed, then you'll be able to land on a hangar, yeah. Notice the back door there. So do you remember the back door on the previous version of the Hull C, where you had this kind of balcony you can come out it's gone. The balcony's gone. I wonder why they removed that.
Don't need it.
And that was a cool viewpoint, I thought.
Oh, but, well, isn't it that thing on the side there? It's just a door, right?
Now it's a door, but it used to be a balcony as well. You can walk out. So I'm not sure why they did that. Maybe it was too easy to...
you could exploit it as
break
a...
Exploit, yeah.
Is the door part of the EVA?
Like probably.
If the point of the door is to be able to EVA, then having to jump over a balcony railing is not productive for that goal.
Yeah, but maybe it's also because they don't want you. If it had a balcony, the balcony would have to have gravity. It would have to be inside of its inside of a gravity field.
So a player
could then stand there and shoot, and use it as a defensive spot while just standing. I don't think it was intended to be able to do that anyway, and they'll let's remove the balcony, and once you get out the door, you're in EVA. So once that happens, you're out of the ship's physics grid, and you will fly off if the ship's moving or be left behind, etc. Just make sure that you can't exploit it as a spot to stand on while it's moving, while it's flying, and shoot at people or whatever you want to do.
I'm curious, is this just a flying pinata?
What do you mean?
How much can it take?
What do you mean, how much can it take? Damage-wise?
It should have decent shields, though, even though it's an industrial ship.
What do you expect that?
Well,
you hope it would, but...
Well, what kind of components does it have?
Isn't it capital class?
Do we know that for
no.
sure?
Oh, no, no, no. Oh, definitely not capital class. I'm guessing it's large components.
Large. If it's yeah. large, then it's immune to however many small fighters that is these days. Five small fighters.
Only five? Okay.
I mean, I don't know what the actual number is, but something like that, right? It's the same as the 890 jump?
It does not have little components, I thought.
Large, large, large. Yeah.
If the 890 has capital size components, then there's no way this doesn't have capital size components.
This is not as large as the 890.
When you extend it, it is.
Yeah, probably. I would assume. Kind of hard to say.
125 meters extended, so.
What, does it say that?
Yeah, there. Well, it says 125. I'm guessing that's division. Yeah. Though I that might be old. We'll have to put a health warning on that. That might be old stats. Because as I said, the ship has gotten slightly bigger. So I remember them talking about they didn't want to extend it, make it too
22 meters
too long, because they wanted it to fit a certain landing pad size.
So yeah, so the 890 is capital class. The Halsey is large. According to the outdated ship matrix, the 890 is 205 meters, and the whole C is 125. But it doesn't say whether that's extended or not extended.
Yeah, and it's probably old data, like you said.
It'll be extended. It's not supposed to be that large. It appears large because of all the cargo containers in it, but it shouldn't be that large. That's where the whole D and whole E come in.
Mm-hmm.
Which I can't wait. Oh, I can't wait for the whole E. This is going to be horrendous looking. Stupidly large. I hope it's grown in size. Because originally it was larger than the Javelin. And then when they redone the Javelin, it ended up to be longer. But I do expect the whole E, when that's done, to be longer and larger than the Javelin. It has to be. It's supposed to be the stupid large container ship that we see like on the seas here.
I'm pretty sure an aircraft carrier is larger than a cargo ship, but I guess that would probably be the Bengal.
Oh yeah, the Bengal will be larger, yeah. But that's a different class altogether. That's the stupid large ships. But yeah, I'm glad I saw that popped up. That was unexpected. Yep. Nice little surprise.
Inside Citizen Live, they were talking to the content team.
Is that what they call them now?
Well, I call them the content team. I forget what they call them for real.
Lore team.
Narrative.
That's the one, yeah.
Wow, it was all there.
Yeah, I don't think there was anything new, really, was there?
Nope.
It was a lot of just reaffirming for probably the newer backers. They haven't been on in a while. Don't recognize him. Don't remember him. He's new.
He had his name, Jeremy Melul, at the bottom. Really tiny Zoom call overlay.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so he seems new.
They've had him West. Not West. But yeah.
Wiser. But I hope he has left. Wiseman, yeah.
Adam Wiser.
He's probably doing something. He's working.
Right.
He's actually working. Everybody else is like just, you know, shooting the breeze on the show.
Oh, do you know what I think he's involved? He's involved with the Squadron 42. He might be over in Manchester. I remember him saying something like that. But yeah, there was nothing really special sticking out here. just answering.
Answering questions, clarifying certain things, retconning other things. But still some interesting tidbits in there, but I think it's more beneficial if you watch it yourself so you can get all that knowledge, because there is a lot of info in there that could be beneficial later if you know it.
Jared wasn't ever...
There was a couple of things. Like they did say that the Dvaran language is still currently underway, working on that.
Yep.
So that's kind of cool if you're into that. Sherry, yeah. Haven't seen Sherry in a while. There is a goal to have Dvarian NPCs in the game.
No shit.
Mm-hmm. Well, you mean you weren't expecting them to be hiding in some corner of the universe?
No, they wouldn't be. You know how this works. Because according to the lore, they've been... What do you call it? The proper term is... I don't know the proper term, but they've been merged with the UEE after their second war.
Assimilated.
Enslaved. Not enslaved. Assimilated. They're technically citizens.
Technically.
Yeah, and just like with current some racial things going on Earth, it takes, even though it was officially assimilated and everything was fine and they're not equal, it doesn't mean that people treat them equally. So there's still quite an issue with Dvaran being ignored, enslaved. Being not a slave, but just being basically cast out. They live, like, they still live
in the future, still act the same.
Yeah, yep. No, what a surprise, weird. This is like what those stories popped up during the election, with the 2050 elections, and I just, because I was covering that on the wiki, and I noticed that they were also talking about Dvaran being banned from voting centers, because they didn't want them in, they want to keep them from voting and stuff like that. Yeah, they're technically citizens. So.
Well, I remember another bit of lore I remember, though I haven't heard anything recently, was that they're already popular for being mercenaries. They're pretty lethal military-wise, and humans do like hiring them to be mercenaries.
Kind of cool.
So hopefully we'll see that.
Hiring them, quote-unquote.
Let's talk about roadmap.
Before we do that, there's a couple of things they actually also mentioned. So even though it's the lore team, of course, I'll take it with a pinch of salt. But one of them did confirm that Xion have tanks. So, I'm not sure.
Well, they were like saying that ground tanks? You would think that every one of the alien races would also have an equivalent to everything that we have. Right? Mm-hmm. Because the Xion, they're a military or a race. They have large militaries and stuff. We've actually fought against them at one point, I think. So, yeah, it would make sense that they would have tanks and stuff like that. Maybe not the Banu so much.
Why wouldn't the Banu have tanks?
Because they're merchants more than... They don't think they've ever had
wars.
Right, so it's a ute instead of a tank. They've got a pickup truck with a fucking 50 cal mounted in the back.
I think they fight, but not with the UAE or anything in that theater.
Are they the ones on the big bad Thanos on the other side of them?
No, that's the Xion. The Xion are the ones that have the big bads on the other side of them. I forgot what they call them, but they have not shared any information with us about them. And then so we have no information about it. But the team did say that they do have all of the information about them, their lore, their history, and blah, 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 for all of the races. It's just that we're not going to have immediate access to all of that stuff. A lot of it will be gathered through either Squadron 42 or through playing Star Citizen and finding that information in your adventures.
Yeah, I mean, personally, I don't give a shit about lore, but...
It does make it richer.
Yeah, no, as you spam enter to skip all of the text in your quest or whatever.
You can buy a few things.
Many of a lot of information have been lost because people just click through all the
skip
paragraphs skip, of text skip, in a quest.
Skip. Yep. Skip.
They added the veal handling improvements into 3.20.
Yes. Desperately needed, I think. Because it feels slightly weird when you use the ground vehicles. It just doesn't seem natural. The ground vehicles are just not right. You know, we've played any other racing game. It's just for some reason, the ground vehicles just don't seem right in Star Citizen.
They're not. So, they've said that themselves. They actually worked on it. They did a segment where they talked about it, but now it looks like they're ready to implement it. I'm sure Realm would be able to show that, but he's too busy playing.
Huh? Where was this? Is this on Inside Star Citizen? Or?
No. I don't know where it's on the roadmap.
Okay.
They did tell us about it in a previous Inside Star Citizen, but it's on the roadmap now. So we're going to get that.
Yep. He was there already. God. Ships and vehicles.
Yeah.
There you go.
And actually, I should have paid closer attention, but 3.2 isn't until the end of Q3. So they got until September to get all this shit done.
Will they?
Well, I hope Q3. So, because I got 3 freaking months.
It'd be interesting because that means they've gone back on track. Because we can.
Well, I don't know if they're back on track, but they got over the big obstacle, which was the Pez.
Have they though? Have they?
Well, a little bit. They got it implemented, let's put it that way.
Now it's just the fine tweaking, really.
Now it's, all the fine tweaking, and then now they're going to start adding all kinds of stuff.
Hmm.
Yeah, and Shady's right. They're just too busy getting CitizenCon ready.
Yeah.
So it's 2 days this year.
2 days. Very surprised with that. What can they do over 2 days? I'm kind of curious.
Will there be a lot more money and stuff?
The panels may be more stretched out, and because even with Frankfurt, the one that I was at, they had panels running together, right? You had to choose, will you go to this panel or that panel? Because they were running at the same time, some of them. Maybe they're just stretching it out.
I'm
now
feeling, this is going to be the one. This is going to be the CitizenCon release, where they're going to start announcing a lot of shit.
What do you want to bet?
What?
Put your money where your mouth is.
Well, why wouldn't they? Why would they not have it at 2 days? It doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah, because what I said is like in the previous ones, it always felt like they were cramming too much in a small amount of time, and they wanted too many panels, and you had to choose between where you wanted to go to the one or the other. Obviously, you can always watch them later separately, but for the visitors. I guess it was always better to just stretch it out.
All right,
more
I bet you a dragonfly.
Deal.
So you want
to confirm the bet here? confirm?
He says
what is it exactly?
I think they're going to make the announcement for Squadron 42.
Hmm. Yeah.
I don't think if they give a release date for Squadron 42, it is not in the next, it is not before 2024. So like,
I agree. 2024. I'm thinking 2024.
No, so I'm saying it's not 2024 at all.
Right.
It's
so you're thinking 2025 or beyond. Okay.
I'm saying they make no announcement or it's post 2025 or post 2024. So 2025 and after.
Okay.
What? That doesn't make sense.
Basically, what he's saying is they are either not going to make an announcement, but if they do make an announcement, they are going to announce that it will be released after 20 or sometime in 2025 or beyond. I'm saying that they are going to make an announcement and it will be for 2024.
We'll give you the or sooner. If they say it's coming out next month, then you still get the Dragonfly.
Okay, well, I appreciate that, but I don't think that's going to be the case. My fingers are crossed that it's going to be the end of 2024, you know, like November or something like that.
Well, they're definitely going to make some announcement. That's basically what you're saying.
Yeah.
He wants to pin it on Squadron 42 now.
Now when we say release, is it beta or is it like complete?
Squadron 42 doesn't need a beta.
Chapter one of Squadron 42.
I'm going to say it's going to be complete.
Chapter one. We'll give you the.
Oh yeah, chapter one. Yeah.
Actually, that's something you can also theorize about. Will they need a beta phase, or is everything going to be polished in house?
No, it has to be polished.
No, you would hope it's a single player game. If they've been making all this fucking fuss about, we can't release anything because it's going to spoil Squadron 42 if we give you an Idris to fly, they're not going to give you a beta of a shitty game that's going to ruin them.
Shitty.
Yeah, that's why you release a beta, because you don't have faith in your game.
Oh, I mean, not in the stability.
It's a single player. Stability shouldn't be.
It's probably, enterprise. A single player probably doesn't need beta. You'd think, but then again.
Do they ever do betas? Most betas these days are multiplayer, right?
Yeah, I don't think I've seen a non-early access game release a quote-unquote beta of our single player game. A
non-multiplayer, Assassin's Creed beta?
They're releasing Starfield 5 days early if you pre-order, that's it.
That's not a beta, that's early access.
There's not a single word anywhere about getting into the beta and stuff like that.
Well, couldn't that not be just a kind of a unofficial beta?
No,
you pay and you get this reward. You get to play it sooner than everybody
else. That's just marketing. Helps. They wanted to get more money out of the shields.
Help the developers because they can get information.
They'll have more than enough tools and abilities to do that. All this, it's going to be all hands on deck.
If they weren't done by then,
not help them.
If it wasn't stable enough by the 3 days before launch. And they suddenly realize because of all the people that have paid extra money to get in early, they suddenly realize, oh shit, it's unstable. To them, try and fix it within the amount of time before it actually launches to the rest of the world would be probably really,
really stressful and like that.
Impossible. I mean, if it's not stable by then already, it's
release early access like that, then by the time it releases 5 days later, your game is ruined because if it's unstable. Look at Cyberpunk. Early reviews said it was shit, and it's taken them 4 years to try to write their strategy on that game. And they still haven't sold as many as they thought they were going to. Like, you only hurt yourself by releasing shitty single-player games.
Premium experience ticket, extremely limited upgrade, adds VIP perks to your CitizenCon ticket with access to an exclusive after party on Sunday night. And more.
Okay,
that
so
is not a party I would want to be at.
You're not a former person.
So like, Well, he's right, but I don't understand why they're. Well, I can. It's to my experience, this is always like doing it that way. Kind of always does the exact opposite, because you'd have a bunch of everybody would go for that, would try to go for that, at which point you'll just have a bunch of idiots who are in that category. I mean, it's the same with when we went to events and there was like a separate queue for concierge and subscribers, and then there was another queue for non-subscribers and concierge, just regular backers. And the line for conjurers and subscribers was longer than the queue for the other regular backers. So subscribers just ended up standing in the regular queue at that point. It didn't make any sense. There was no... But then again, here they're limiting the amount of tickets that was sold. So
they have more control over this. But this is... I don't know how much room they're renting from the LA Convention Center. This is one of the largest convention centers in the country.
Did they actually just confirm that they were going there now?
Yeah.
So I really think they're just playing a game when it comes to limited access to 2,000 people.
Well, no, it's not. It's limited access to certain events and stuff. Right, so the limited act, the VIP thing is an after party. So it's going to be, you know, you have to have a ticket to get into this party where you'll get to, you know, hobnob with Chris and Sandy. You know, where you actually don't even get to hobnob with them. You have to just stand in a huge line to get autographs and stuff like that.
Yeah, and like Silo said, you get both tickets, get you access to all the CitizenCon, all the regular CitizenCon content over the 2 days, so you can you have the same but I guess the extra perks with the after party and whatever else there is they didn't specify yet. VIP perks.
You get to suck Chris Roberts' dick.
I really wish they had put the price down. You know, apparently they got so much pressure. Zytel made a separate announcement.
Initially they didn't. Right, I'm surprised there. They so let's talk to. About the price.
Yeah, it's an expensive event.
$300 for both days.
It is different
VIP.
It's really, I guess, the event really is much more different than it was 4 or 5 years ago. Anyway, I don't even know how much I paid for the one that I went to in Frankfurt.
I know how much I paid for the Austin ticket. The Austin ticket was $87.
Yeah, it was under $100, I think, for me too. Pretty sure.
So. Knowing that this will be in the LA Convention Center, I knew it would be at least that price plus an extra $100.
And that price is about right for most conventions that you spend multiple days. The $199, at least in the US, is about right.
For a day?
No.
Yeah.
The $199 is for the weekend or the 2 days.
Oh, 2 days. Yeah, sorry.
Okay. Both tickets are for 2 days. Yeah.
Yeah, the $299 or the $300 is to get you into the party.
Yes, or just don't hang around.
Or whatever else they give you in regards to that as well.
BlizzCon is 2 days, and the tickets are $275. So Star Citizen is fucking robbing you at that price.
But then again, BlizzCon, they announce stupid mobile games like Diablo Immortal and.
Right, but that's a hugely more productionized convention.
Is it though?
With significantly more people, yeah.
Because this one's going to be even more extensive than the previous CitizenCon, so don't underestimate what they're pulling here. I don't think we should. I mean, if they're setting these prices, you'd expect a decent.
Hell, Mark Hamill could show up at the party.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe that's also why why Innovis may be right, because if they're really pulling out all the stops, and like if you can kind of tell by the price of this and the fact that it's 2 days, maybe they're getting into Quantum 42 content.
It would just make sense for them to do that.
But then again, if they're not, we would be grossly disappointed.
So. Yeah, I mean, you know, we can roll our eyes and say, oh, yeah, I remember Squadron 42 2016. Yeah, yeah. But we all know that eventually they're going to have to announce the release of the game.
2014 first.
No, 2015.
Well, I'm going
16
by,
was the revised date.
Yeah.
Yeah, 16 was the video.
The trailer, yeah.
So eventually we all know they're going to have to release a game, and why not release it in these conditions? Remember, they took the Squadron 42 price thingy away.
Yeah, still think that's weird, but anyway.
It's funny, they didn't even take that video down.
They will put it back up when they make their announcement at CitizenCon.
It'll be $70.
It'll be $100.
It's all revenue opportunity.
Yeah, we talked about this. It was likely to be an increase anyway because it's treated as an actual full AAA separate title now, which just make it a $70 game instead of $45, as it was previously thought that it was just half of a full game, that Star Citizen was $45 and Squadron 42 was $45 or whatever.
They've always said that were two separate games, and yeah, they've always said that they were going to raise the price once they were closer to release, and they are going to treat them as two separate games, and they're going to charge us for two separate games, or they're going to charge newer people. Because almost everybody else has already fucking bought the games. And have been fucking waiting forever.
Yeah, I think of two or three copies by now.
Oh my god.
That's a 10-year-old trailer.
So basically, for the next 3 months, we got nothing.
Well, hopefully
they've already told us everything that they're going to give us in the next 3 months, because if they throw any more in there, they're going to miss their deadline again.
Not necessarily. They still could throw things in.
Like what? What is fire?
I don't know.
Fire?
Maybe
fire.
They could probably put in fire.
Fire and fire hydrogen. I still think they should have put the fire in before they got the fire extinguisher.
Nemesis could appear.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In LA.
Fireball.
This guy who, I don't know who he is. Who's this guy?
That's you.
That me? Better trim than me.
No, not him. The other one. The one that walked up to him. That's you.
Oh, him, the player. All right.
Yeah.
Lieutenant.
That other guy, he's the old man, whatever, you know.
Yeah, I think he was in some other movie.
Some other game, too. It's been a few games.
A few games, yeah. Yeah, I hope a few of them will appear. That'll be nice. I may be idealistic, but...
Yeah.
But it would be nice.
It wouldn't surprise me.
I will say, if you don't have at least one celebrity from the game show up live,
Nicolas Cage.
I'm not talking about videos. I'm talking Nicolas about Cage. Actually physically there.
Keanu
I will
Reeves.
Be disappointed. I would be disappointed. Yeah, really. Oh yeah, he's one of the secret characters they didn't tell us about.
That'd be hilarious.
I mean, how cool would that
see,
be?
See, Nicolas Cage. I said that. Because he also appeared recently with the... Was it with the Xbox thing? That was one of that last week. He appeared on on stage with one of the presentations that got made recently in the game he's in. Because they apparently people... Devs are doing that now. Companies are reeling in actors, you know, to spearhead their project and be like, look how cool we are. We got Nicolas Cage.
Do you know why? Because people aren't going to movies, so they're not making fucking money. They're like, okay, well, people playing video games, pay me. I'll be in your video game. Pay me.
Yeah, this is Gary right. Oldman. It makes sense.
Gary Oldman could be there.
Yep.
Or him.
Did he retire?
Or him.
Who, Gary Oldman?
Uh-huh.
Oh, those guys are British.
Semi-retired. He still does stuff now and again, but...
I'm thinking about that guy who played Lincoln, who retired.
Oh, him? No. Why did he retire?
He said he did. I could be wrong, though.
I doubt it. He still got a good few years left in him.
Now, almost all the rest of the characters in Squadron 42 are British actors. So they may or may not... I would be surprised if any of the British actors showed up.
Why not? That's an easy fly from London to LA. Why not?
It's just an added cost.
Henry Cavill.
Maybe they don't want to.
Oh my God! I pay $500 to see him.
Oh, Henry! Yoo-hoo, Henry!
Over here.
I love you, Henry.
Damn.
How much would you pay for that VIP ticket, Rad?
Oh, Shady, that would be so fucking cool if it was. That would be funny. Keanu Reeves as the head of the OMC gang.
That's right, we don't know who that is. Yeah, there's still a lot of people we don't know who. Yeah, that could be possible. You never know.
That would be funny. That'd be awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm actually going through the list here, and you're right, they're all over in Europe. There's very few US actors, surprisingly. Again, that's using the London connection.
Discounts. Using those tax write-offs.
Monitor Hamill's Twitter the next couple months. See if he gives any hints as to his location.
Yeah.
Doesn't he live in LA?
Yeah, but he may be traveling. I mean, it all depends. You know, some Star Wars crap maybe, or he's currently in a new movie that's coming out or something, where he's the father of a guy that said he was a.
The Machine. Yeah. It's a great comedy special if you haven't seen the original that's based off of.
Oh.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see. They haven't said anything about... Well, I guess they're going to be broadcasting it, right?
Well, I hope so.
Or at least they'll broadcast something, maybe like 1 hour, a couple hours or something like that, and then the rest of it was only for the people that are actually there.
Mm-hmm.
Because I can't see them doing 2 days of streams.
No, I can. But you're right, I still think there will be events that they won't be showing live, and they'll probably show it later as a recorded event.
Yeah, probably.
But no, they'll definitely do the 2 days. They have to. Everybody will be going ape if they don't have the second day.
Yeah, but he's saying if they have like 5 stages going on, then they're not going to stream all 5 stages.
No. Not live, anyway.
Yeah, they're probably going to record it and release
it. So did they say what are the actual dates of CitizenCon?
Yeah, 24th and 22nd.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, 24th, 2nd of...
October.
Yeah, October. There's 124 days, 10 hours, and 33 minutes.
Okay.
Save the date.
Mark your calendars.
or don't.
So
ask your boss for off time.
Yeah, I think this year would be worth taking off time.
What, to watch it?
Yeah, why not?
It's already on Saturday anyway.
Don't do that. Go get paid. Don't deal with the fucking glitches and inability for them to stream things correctly. All of the technical difficulties.
You'd be better watching it later, yeah.
Trace is on a weekend, so it's not like people will be losing time.
Go outside and touch some grass.
And where? In mid-October?
Yes.
With a coat on.
And then come back when they release it all on YouTube and somebody has taken that and condensed it down into a 12-minute video of all the important shit. Save yourself like 6 hours.
All right, Noob Fire.
So you've never had, you didn't even contemplate of going and get some beer and food and, you know.
Oh, 0% chance.
Oh, wow. Okay. Maybe you're the one that needs to touch grass. Or maybe go into the water and have a swim.
I will, yeah.
Yeah. Go to Boston Harbor there. Jump in.
Pass on that.
I wonder what we'll get. So ticket holders will get exclusive swag, both physical and digital, as they say.
Probably.
But will we get anything? Or will we have to pay for it?
I get digital stuff.
I'm sure you'll have to pay for digital. They said digital pack.
They said people with the tickets would get both digital and physical goodies, but
yeah.
Previously, they've also been selling separate goodie packs, digital goodie packs, for anyone else that wanted to throw money on in the Play Store. Which probably different items than the people that have the tickets, though. Because they want to be feeling special.
I still have the special
two guns from my Centagon.
I was telling Wee that I think I'm going to go.
You think?
I think.
you're very excited about it.
Well, yeah, 80-20%.
Okay. No, it would be cool to go to. No doubt about it.
If I could get the tickets, I might go. Because there's going to be a rush of the gates to get the tickets, and if you ain't quick enough.
Yeah, Innovis, I don't know about that. I'm thinking that's just total hype. You know, I think they did the same thing with Austin. They sold them in waves and in, you know, so-called limited numbers, but it was enough.
It depends, really. Like, the LA Center is huge.
Yeah, and we have no idea how much space they're renting.
You could always volunteer to go and work and get in for free, but you'll be working.
Yeah.
It's not like free. You're selling your soul. Free.
I mean, are they going to pay for my
volunteer stuff?
The flight. Are they going to pay for my room and board?
Nope. I don't think so.
Exactly. So I'm paying them. No.
Aren't we all paying them right now?
Well, yeah. Rather, you know, pay them and walk around and drink and talk and
not be the one that has to clean up the shit afterwards.
Yep.
No, it's not that one, Realms, the one next door, the square one. Yeah.
Yeah. What, this?
Yeah.
What's the difference? I thought, isn't the whole thing a complex?
No, it's the same. So it's all one complex, but there's different centers. So that's the bigger one. If it's the same one as the one that was canceled because of COVID, then it's the square one.
Well, they didn't say which hall it is, right? They just said it's at the convention and it's on those 2 days. Actually, you know what? Just go to their website.
Actually, that's a good idea. Yes. Look at the LA Convention Center. They'll have it on their schedule since it's now being confirmed, or it should be there anyway.
I did look. They do sell alcohol, but it's an inside vendor of the convention itself, so there probably will be alcohol.
Watered down alcohol?
Maybe not. Don't know.
That's September, October.
It's nothing. 21-22?
Not listed yet.
Interesting.
North American Spine Society ends on Friday.
Yeah, so the Spine Society before that, and then the Society of Women Engineers the following.
On Wednesday, yeah.
Open to public now.
They use the West Hall as a parking garage.
The LA Comic Con is in December.
Yeah, it's not listed. Yeah. Yet.
Well, last time it was the West, so it's possible. You're right. It's possible it could be the main one. Which is probably why it's more expensive. But that's a big venue. It's probably why they chose the West South initially Hall. Because it's a smaller one.
What is this?
That's the basketball stadium, I think.
Oh.
For the what's the LA team called?
Lakers,
yes. Which I find strange because where's the Lakers?
Crypto Arena.
Exactly.
Under LA.
Laker. Oh, good lord. Okay.
Wow, look at all that parking. At least they got solar panels over it.
Is it? Okay.
Looks like it.
I don't covered. Think those are solar panels.
There's a tram line nearby, so that's cool.
And a giant highway.
Life is a highway.
But there'll be a few Airbnbs about there. I'm not sure now how easy it will be to get a hold of one. So yeah. That'll be fun.
I can't believe they're having the party on Sunday night. You would think they would do it on Saturday night, but then they would probably overdo it and not be very functional.
Dude,
everyone
would take off Monday. Right? Anyway. Like, if you're doing a 2-day event like that, you'd be sure people won't be going back to work on Monday.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I'm not coming in tonight, boss. I'm sick of it.
Yeah. Monday, you'll be at Santa Monica Beach just getting the hangover gone, you know? That's what you'll be doing. Anyway, so that's that. So do we delve in the dark side
of
this? Go into
the salt. Would you wake up Jen down for this?
Go for it, because I have no idea what you guys are talking about it.
Well, he won't know anything about it.
No.
Well, I don't know. If he pops in, then I guarantee the others will pop in.
what's the dark side of the community? What's going on?
So a guy called Blue the Robot. He was
Blue
a streamer.
Blue the Robot, what a name.
I've seen worse.
Judging already.
So
that's what you asked us here to do, right?
He asked a very valid request.
Well, he's a new, kind of new to the community, right?
Yeah.
Is what he said. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And he asked Katie Byrne of Will and Kate fame.
Citizen Kate,
even, yeah, who came over from Elite Dangerous and has done pretty well with her videos, and he's even set up an org around her. And yeah, he made a valid request to, can he do a video based on her and her org? And, well, she replied quite rudely, I have to say. I really was surprised about. Very cold, I think. She basically said that absolutely no chances, you can see, because she wanted, she said she created this org for the sole purpose of her making money. This is her business. Which I think is disgraceful. It's a game, for crying out loud. It's not a business. And even in the whole scale of gaming, her level of success is nowhere near other games. It's tiny, really tiny, insignificant, really. Maybe not to us, but on the whole scale of things, it's really small. And she's saying that this is, she refused because she's involved in a cutthroat business.
Well, she thinks the YouTuber is a rival like channel. That,
and she's I'm gonna say
you're my rival.
That she, if the guy's butt fucked, butt hurt because she basically told him no in a very straight, dedicated. You know, she could have sugarcoated it a little bit, or just said thank you for your interest, but no, we don't want to do anything. But she's right. YouTube is cutthroat. YouTube is
it?
Everybody is on their own and stuff like that. And she has a valid point in that we have this guild, we have the assets, we use it for our own stuff, and I don't want to share that with anybody else.
Wow. Okay. You've read that. Absolutely, totally different than practically everybody else. Forgive me.
But YouTube shouldn't be that. For some
YouTube
people, it is like
is
that, but
super
competitive.
Be.
The content creators
shouldn't be like this.
Because there are definitely creators
that
do. Yes, but even then, there are still definitely creators that you can see are collaborating with others.
It doesn't matter.
Even the same, branch of gaming content and stuff.
I understand your point of view because you are one of those individuals that want to provide content for the sake of providing content. But the reality is, all the streamers, right?
Yeah, but you think of it as
are in it for the money,
profitable,
as well as YouTube.
But sometimes,
not only do they stream, they also go to YouTube. It's a business.
Yeah, but sometimes even collaborating can be profitable, as you can see.
Can be, but she doesn't want to collaborate.
No,
and actually, I don't blame her, mainly because I've watched her content, and her content is really good. And to share that with somebody else is basically giving away their proprietary content.
I have a counterpoint. Why the fuck do we care about either one of these people?
it's the attitude of her. Really doggone rude it was.
Well, it's kind of an attitude that...
She was rude.
Okay, so let me ask you a question.
I'm not going to leave Miami saying this. Everybody's saying that.
So you're saying she was rude.
Absolutely.
But you are not saying she was wrong.
Well, it's her
choice. Her choice to say yes or no. But the way she went about it was absolutely,
you know, people are assholes. I'm one of them.
But she doesn't come across as an asshole on our content. But now
she's putting on a character. Who cares what she comes across in content? That's a business. It's a front to make money.
It's not a business, it's a game.
No, Star Citizen is a business selling you a video game, and content creators is a business that uses video games to make money.
Yeah,
and they make up content, they make up personalities, they make up drama, and they make up their entire lives to make money. So
it's kind of also why I posted this was because I also just I feel like this is what has become of these types of content creators nowadays, which are just so individualistic nowadays. It is that their whole the whole fact that online content creation is now all about you and your own channel and your own thing, and nobody else, everybody else is your rival. It's kind of sickening at some point where it should be media used to be about making creating a team of broadcasting individuals that you can get together and make your own channel, like an actual TV channel, and conservative terms, and then you'd have a good team and you would work together to make great content. Now it's just every noob can make a Twitch channel or YouTube channel and make their own stuff, but that'll just make everyone also never work together.
Relevant, if I'm a grocery store, right?
Yeah, but it's still all about her.
If I'm a grocery store and you come to me and you're starting a sticker business and you say, hey, I want to make stickers that look like products that you sell in your grocery store. Why do I give a fuck about you? Why am I going to risk my brand to help you out when I get nothing from it? You're small time and have nothing to offer me.
So is this risking your brand?
You're not going to. Yes.
He just asked for a little bit of.
Yes, but he's talking about her. He's asking for access. He's going to make content about her. That is a risk to your brand because that is a narrative you don't control. And any narrative you don't control is a risk to your brand.
And guess what?
Especially when your brand is narrative.
He's like, already attacking her brand by posting this. He didn't have to do that.
He's doing this for the same reason
she said no. He's doing this for press.
I don't believe in that kind of apology.
He is doing it to get the attention and to get everybody to go to watch his stuff because she said no.
Well, he is leveraging that.
He is trying to root in her reputation with that attitude.
That is a shitty.
It's the business world. It's not fucking fairy tale land.
I can make another analogy. It's like because it's also like. You could also see it like a journalist trying to do coverage about something. Whether or not you collaborate with them, they'll make the story anyway. And in some kinds of times, like this case, it can even backfire to you because if you're being shitty about not wanting to collaborate with them, they'll just run the story and even provide the details about how you didn't even want to work with them. To provide, which would probably be even be a really fair coverage of her org that this what was his name, Lou the Robot, wanted to make about that part of this community, but she didn't want to collaborate.
Again, look at like mod communities, right? In general, people think mods are great. People love mods, but. When somebody makes a mod for a game that infringes on another company's intellectual property, they sue the fuck out of them. And that sometimes upsets a community, but has that ever hurt, really, EA's bottom line? No, because they're bigger and they have more to worry about from protecting their intellectual property than some small fringe group of the internet that... is pissed that they canceled their favorite little mod. It's business. It's not friends. It's not a community. It's I'm here to make money. You're here to make money. You're trying to use me to make money. And I'm going to say no.
There was this apology thing. I think it was a screenshot from a YouTube post update or whatever. It was like she basically says, "Oh, I was in a shitty mood when I replied."
Yeah, I mean, like I said, she probably should have used some soft skills to make it a little less abrupt. But I guarantee you that no matter how she phrased it, whether it was rude or not, this guy would have posted it and said she's being unreasonable. He would have put a spin on it. Just like everybody else does, to make it look like she's a bitch and she doesn't want to play nice with everybody else.
Why would he have done
that?
And
then he gets the attention and
drama drives clicks, because that's the entire part of this business.
That's what you make money on. If you look at this, based on his tweet, it looked like he didn't even want to cover. Here's the bad side of this thing. He just wanted to cover the org in a good way.
Look at it from this perspective. All he had
but
to
she
do
made it bad.
Was after she said no, was say, okay, thank you.
Right.
I won't bother you.
Oh,
not taking this
was,
with grace.
He was giving.
He could
really
have just
weird
as easily
arguments.
Said, "Hey, I'm sorry. I'm sorry if I offended you, or I got, you know, whatever."
That's what he did.
I won't bother you again. And then he could have gone and tried another org.
That's not what he did. He said that.
That's not what he did.
And then published it for clicks.
He kept poking her. He kept poking her to get her to continue to respond and make it look like she's the bad guy.
He explained his request was not to disrespect her, even though she reacted rudely.
His entire purpose here is to make money. That's why he published it. If you are saying that he has any ulterior motive, you're lying to yourself. Because if he was pure of heart, he wouldn't have published it.
Well, journalists aren't about making money either.
And she could have.
He's not a journalist. He's a content creator trying to drive up.
Journalists make money.
Had she said thanks but no thanks and kept it at that, and been somewhat nice, maybe he would have responded in something else. But it was her. It was up to her to respond to him.
Right.
And
the first thing he thought of was, this is going to make great content that people are going to click on. This will drive up my viewership.
Trey, what I'm saying is, she gave him that opening by responding to him afterward.
She did. They are both content creators. Neither one of them is pure here. He had no reason to leak this conversation, but he chose to get pity and to get likes and to get clicks and to make money.
Yeah. And to me, from my perspective, she gave him that opening.
She did.
Oh, she did.
They're both in their right, but no one is wrong here. Or no one has a moral high ground here.
No, there's a thing called common courtesy, and she just could have said no, thank you.
And he didn't follow common courtesy either.
But she didn't.
He didn't have to.
I'd say he was much more professional in his reply than her, so that's probably...
No, he wasn't. He was not professional because he kept responding to her and poking her and trying to convince her to let him go in. He was not being
trying to understand why she had such an attitude in the first place.
He should have just, at that point, he should have just said, I'm out of here.
I would have done exactly the same.
Like you're defending her.
I want to know why. What's with the attitude? The request I made was a simple one, and you could simply say no and walk away. But no, she gave this whole bloody response. Unnecessary. Absolutely unnecessary.
Yeah,
actually,
there's probably 70 people that email her the same shit every day.
Probably.
And you get tired of leeches trying to leech off of your success. So you got to put one down every once in a while.
Trade success. I mean, come on. She's not mythologist here. She only has 35,000 people.
No Star Citizen streamers are successful in the grand scheme of success. But the people who are the worst at it are the people, like the people who have the worst attitudes are the people who are minorly successful. Because it goes straight to their fucking head that they have 1,000 subscribers or something. They think they're hot shit. And the people who try to leech off of them are no better because they're leeching off of nothing already. Mm-hmm. And you're trying to get blood from a stone.
And then there are other content creators that then give their opinion about this, yada, yada, yada.
Yeah, this annoys me as he's trying to create another narrative here. I'm not sure it's a deliberate or not, but...
trying to throw this onto the LGBTQ issues pile.
I mean, he's right that she is...
But people would always be doing this. It doesn't...
There is no moral high ground here. This guy shouldn't have posted it if he was really the morally superior person that he's trying to make himself out to be.
She was rude. I think he's totally right to show that she was rude. Nothing wrong with that.
He's trying to make money and she's trying to make money. There's nothing wrong with her being rude from a content creation point of view, and there's nothing wrong with him posting it from a content creation point of view. They're both fucking scum.
She was probably a good example of how this may be going on in lots of other parts of the YouTube content creator community, which is also maybe why he posted. So it was kind of what I said earlier. What my idea behind him posting that was probably because it shows you something that happens, might happen quite often in that community, just as a general statement that he wanted to show this, not particularly to harm her.
Did he offer her money?
But to just show that people can be shitholes in this community, in this YouTube business.
Did he offer her money or to share the profit from his video?
Well, they didn't even get that far. He may have, but we don't know that.
I mean, but that's not how business works. You don't say, hey, I'm going to make this thing about you. I'd like access and not include and I would like to share my money with you up front. If you don't put it up front, it's not your intention to do that.
But it's exposure. Exposure.
She doesn't need exposure. Tons of exposure. She's doing
smaller great. Than she is.
And here's the thing. This one person that's trying to, it's like Trade said, they can't control the narrative. That person can just as easily say, yeah, I want to do an expose on you and show you, you know, and show your group and stuff like that. He can show her as being a completely horrible view versus a good view. You know, it's like they don't control how they're going to present them.
No.
She was in a bad mood when he replied. He was in a bad mood when he tweeted. No one's innocent. No one's good. They're both out to make money.
I'm still going to watch her videos. She's got good stuff.
I still have no idea who either one of them are.
No, yeah. Oh, I'm not going to watch him. He's a nobody. He's trying to become a somebody. But she does a lot of videos for Star Citizen, and they test all of the patches and all of the features, and they're a well-organized group. They do a lot of tactical stuff and everything, so it's very entertaining to watch and informative at times. And I think everybody can relate. Everybody has a bad day. So don't tell me, Wee, that there isn't a time when someone says something to you and you're like, fuck off, go away.
I don't do it.
I don't feel like it's just about
someone has a bad day. I'm sure she didn't do it intentionally either.
Text, that's weird. That's a strange. Doing it on text takes effort. You know, you can just simply say no thank you and walk away.
Not if you're in a bad mood. In a bad mood, you let everything out.
If you're in a bad mood, you still just say no thank you and walk away.
Who cares? Let's just say she's an actual dick. Why does it matter?
You're like trying to defend someone who is kind of like trying to defend someone who's drunk and who then does illegal stuff, or, you know, I don't know, does criminal stuff while being drunk.
That's a totally different scenario.
Still liable.
And is not appropriate.
Doesn't mean
telling someone to fuck off can be excused.
Is like
telling someone that they're drunk and they get into an accident and cover for them is a totally different thing.
I still don't know why it matters.
It won't matter anyway, because when Star Citizen goes live, fully live, if ever, the bigger streamers will come in and absolutely wipe these two off the face of existence. So.
Correct.
And does.
We don't have an existence.
Oh, no, we'll still be around.
There are seven bots that watch this show.
Yeah. Shush.
And does.
This is just a glimpse into what this Discord looks like on a Tuesday.
Y'all usually aren't in here on a Tuesday, so I don't know what you're talking about.
What do you mean? We're around here all the time.
All the damn time. That's a lie.
Okay.
How do you know that? Are you here all the time?
Yeah.
I look and see if anyone's in here.
He's a lurker.
Not really.
Rad, be the change you want to be. Sit in the channel. Then other people will look in the channel, see if there's someone there, and there will be.
No, because he who shall not be named may pop in the channel.
Oh, dear.
Voldemort.
Oh, you're funny.
Dark Smart.
It's a risk that you have to take, Rad.
No.
Roll the dice.
I don't know why you hate that kid so much. It's not very nice.
Oh, that got him out.
Wow, we were the talking about shitty internet.
I went and made coffee. Time. Took a minute.
Wow.
Coffee. I wouldn't mind coffee, but if no milk, though.
You missed it then.
Yeah, don't be racist.
Probably good.
Just drink it black.
Yeah.
Yeah. Asshole.
He wouldn't have known about it anyway. So
long story short, everyone should just quit streaming and give their communities to Jun Tao to shepherd into the future.
I don't think that's probably not a good idea.
I can share the tweet anyway, and everybody in the you don't even know what you signed up for. In the team can read the shitty community.
I don't care about that shit. About I think she's right.
No, I don't think they both are just trying to make money. Let's not give them more publicity because that's what they really want.
But I do know of one Star Citizen YouTuber who says whatever money he generates, he's giving it to veterans to play games.
Does he have receipts?
One would hope.
Well, doesn't Board Gamer, his money goes to looking after his brother, doesn't it?
That's money. That's not charity.
No, it's a personal charity, but...
But you're right. This shouldn't matter, but it's just the rudeness of her reply.
They're both rude.
You don't know. He could be...
He published a private conversation. That's rude.
That's not rude.
It is.
No, it's not. He showed how rude she was, and I think he was right of showing how rude she was.
His entire motive was to make money.
I don't know that. You don't know if he did it because, well, she was rude to me. I'm going to show the world who.
That's exactly what you're saying he did.
You know. Well, I'm eating popcorn.
Principle.
The principle to get more clicks.
You think he did it solely to get more clicks?
Yes.
You don't know.
He's a content creator.
That was not his initial intention. Right. Yeah. But in the end, he benefits off of this, and she benefits off of this also.
Oh, absolutely. That's why Shady was right. They're both, you know, were wrong. But it's still, the initial act was by her, and that's what I'm annoyed about.
He didn't offer to profit share. So he was the rude one. He's trying to make free content off of her. They didn't even get that far. They did. You don't lead a business proposal without the monetary aspect.
Not a business proposal. It was just
Miami nailed it right on the head. The last sentence in his most recent one. And I don't know who the fuck is Blue. Exactly. He's a no one. He's doing this so that he becomes someone. That's the only reason why he did it.
It doesn't work like that.
Yes, it does.
We know who he is now. Are you going to watch his videos?
Fuck no.
His Twitter feed is Blue the Robot, no, YouTuber, 5.3.
Somebody is.
5. I'm still going to watch Kate.
5.3K subs, Pro 2A Pew, Pog Army Vet, WW3 The Game Partner, Discord, YouTube. Okay.
Stop giving him publicity.
The BlueRobot.tv. Who cares? Publicity to the 6 bots we have watching this, you mean?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
There are plenty of stupid people.
We've rattled on for half an hour about this thing, so. Let's get the hell out of here.
We got content out of it, too. Look at it that way.
Yeah.
Except y'all ain't making any money. Look at it that way, too.
Well, we're rolling the money.
Subscribers just came in like massively. Like, oh, look, those dudes are talking about the salt of the community. Well, give them money.
We get like half a cent for this.
You know what we need, folks?
It's from iPrime subs, by the way.
We need one of Juntal's legendary salty comments on the game. Go ahead, Juntal. Give it to us.
I have no idea what the fuck is going on anywhere.
Sounds like you've been a father for a long time. Good.
I popped in this show 2 weeks ago, started a whole bunch of drama, and fucked off for a couple of weeks, and here I am again. So
that's so true. Oh my god, drama did you start?
Oh no.
I don't know. Somebody got upset because I referred to
Kate
as a weird Euro girl streamer or some shit like that. I don't know. That's because I have no idea who the fuck she is either, and I honestly don't give a fuck.
Wow, I'm offended.
Everybody should be offended, for fuck's sake.
I'm offended that you're offended.
No, I'm offended
that you're offended that I'm offended.
Now keep doing that. I'll run the outro. You.
So, Junta, are you going to go to CitizenCon?
Oh, yeah, CitizenCon. Yeah.
I don't think
he ain't going
to
step foot in California.
I just,
Michigan. They should all leave California. They should.
She told you.
Everybody should exit that fucking shithole. Go to Florida, Tennessee, Texas.
No. Florida's just as fucked up, dude. DeSantis is fucking everything up.
Yeah. Nope, don't come to Florida. Somewhere near you.
I don't know. All the money's moving to fucking Florida and Tennessee right now.
Texas, too.
Move to Massachusetts. It's the richest and highest standard of living state in the country.
Nobody else in fucking Massachusetts. It's already packed.
Look, you can move to the western part. It's a bunch of hillbillies who have the best standard of living of all the hillbillies in the country. So
they could do the country a favor and all move to West Virginia and help that shithole out.
Oh, God.
They could, but why would they do that?
Tax breaks.
They get plenty of tax breaks in Massachusetts.
Mm-hmm. What's going
like
on?
Everything like rots in Massachusetts from the fucking salt in the air.
There was something popped up there about pad rammers, but I'm not going to bother.
Pad rammers.
Oh, pad rammers.
They're back again?
Again.
No, there's this YouTuber who's famous for being a complete a-hole in Planetside. And he's rearing his head now in Star Citizen, and he streams and does pad ramming.
How many people pre-ordered Starfield?
I haven't yet, but I'm thinking about it.
Pre-order?
I got the deluxe edition.
What? What did he tell you?
It's going to have like Fallout in space.
Don't fucking pre-order.
Star Wars Outlaws looks okay.
It's made by EA.
Yeah, but it looks okay.
No, it's Activision.
Yeah, it's
Ubisoft, right?
Yeah, it's Ubisoft.
Yeah, I don't do Ubisoft or EA games.
At least not pre-order anyway.
Chris Roberts games.
At least it's not longer.
Yeah, but I don't do Chris Roberts games either.
But we know. Yeah, but you know, but Bethesda's games are just as buggy when they come out too. So.
But
it should still be better.
You know,
there are no like good game developers anymore. Everything is tainted. It's weird.
Yeah, it's by the consolidation. Everything's everyone was bought by somebody who's a shithole.
Mm-hmm.
And the bigger companies all only have one purpose.
Yep, make money.
But I would rather put my money where my mouth is and say, hey, you were releasing a game. I'm proud of you. Not perpetual development. Here's some cash.
This is why all the merging, why specifically also the Xbox and Microsoft trying to acquire Activision Blizzard as well, and why this is so fiery. The whole debate is so dense because every time something merges, everything some big company acquires something, gets bigger and gets bigger and gets bigger. It becomes the next villain in town. It creates a shitload of games, but only with one purpose: making money. They will monetize that shit to hell, at which point everybody will be like, just like how everybody was against EA or against the whole monetization with Diablo 3. And it's just,
if they put out a game,
indies are really good for the
money, then that's fine.
But they won't.
If they put out crap.
I'm good with capitalism, obviously. I gave Chris Roberts like a couple
too
new
much
copies.
Money.
Indies and startups are really good for the
with charity, you know?
For the branch as well. And they're starting to disappear.
There's too many fucking games getting churned out constantly, so it's hard to like decipher what is going to be a quality product and what isn't.
And the thing, Realm, you know, just because Microsoft buys a company like Bethesda doesn't stop independent game developers from building their own games and putting them out there.
No, it makes them easier to get washed out of the business because of the big companies. Oh, it does.
No, it doesn't.
But you know what they do?
Go ahead.
They put them on fucking early access on Steam every fucking time. Every time. And then you go, you know what? That looks like it's going to be a good game. And then you freaking check it out and it's like 10% complete.
But it's only $20. So.
But it's only $20.
Yeah. I mean, there are plenty of independent companies that, you know, they release something and they freaking blow up because they release a great game. Now, whether or not they decide to sell themselves to a bigger company or not, that's up to them. But they can continue to make other games and stuff like that. The big companies like Microsoft and Sony and all that, they buy all the other studios so they can have exclusivity. So that they can promote their hardware.
Yeah, which is also not a very good sign.
Well, they're dumb because when you do exclusivity, you eliminate potential revenue, even though it's the competition. So what you want to do is not permanent exclusivity, but maybe time exclusivity. So that you can actually get...
That backfired with Star Wars.
They're kind of really doing that now.
Yeah, the Jedi thing. Yeah.
But the thing is, you can still make money.
10-year exclusivity or
whatever
it was.
I'm saying, you know, you give them like 6 months exclusivity or something like that.
And port it to PC.
And then you give it to the PlayStation or whatever. You know, that kind of thing.
That's why you just develop by Xbox. Xbox does... PC and Xbox every because release.
Microsoft owns everything.
Don't you see that they won't pull the Xbox forward on that regard? If they can release something on PC, that doesn't mean that they will.
I mean, they do. They are. They double release every game, as far as I'm aware.
Yeah,
except Microsoft, maybe Halo might be the one holdout, but
no, Halo's been released on PC.
Now
was it released at the same time?
Oh, I don't know about the same time. No, I don't know about that.
Yeah. Most games not made by like Xbox are dual released.
Mm.
It's the PS4 games or PS5 or PS12, whatever they're up to now, that don't dual release because they're not developing on a Windows system to start with.
Yep. So, and actually, Sony are the ones that are not playing nice. Because they're the only ones that do full exclusivity and they for their PlayStation and stuff. And they won't necessarily even release it on a PC. And they don't support cross-platform for most of their games. They're the ones that aren't playing nice.
Sony's going full-on live service games as well. It's going to be a shit show.
Yep.
Being
but
like,
it is what it is.
Live service game. It no longer works. Let's kill it, and nobody can play it anymore.
I mean, we can only either ignore their stuff and not buy it, or we just go ahead and give in and buy it. That's the way it works.
Most people are so desperate for something to grasp their attention and give them their dopamine that they will buy whatever. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter who sells it. Doesn't matter if it's a criminal who sells it.
That's called drugs.
Well, I like drugs.
Drugs is good.
I heard fentanyl was kicking right now.
Should we go? Was there anything on the...
There is Alien Week.
All right, bunch of skins. That's it.
Don't give them your fucking money.
It was a really weird trailer.
Queen or some shit now, right? They got enough money.
The trailer is brilliant. I love the way that the Banu see us.
When CIG releases the game, you can then decide if it's worth playing and give them your money. But before you do that, I would ask you to rate the amount you spend on games by hours of enjoyment per dollar spent.
Who? Why? No one listens to you.
Hours of enjoyment per dollar spent. Are you ever going to get the same ratio in Star Citizen that you get on any other game? The answer is no.
The answer is yes. You know why?
Pick is City Skylines 2.
Yeah, buying that shit.
I'm buying that shit. I will have thousands of hours in that fucking game, and I will definitely get my money's worth out of it because I have to recover all the shit I lost on Star Citizen somewhere.
Yeah.
Into time.
Fucking games I bought on Steam for $5, I have 1,000 hours in. I don't think I have more than 200 hours in Star Citizen.
Oh, we probably do, but we were just fucking jerking off. And that was like, however, 6-7 years ago.
Yeah. I might have more hours playing Skyrim on my fridge than I have on Star Citizen.
Oh, shit. I don't know. I still have hope. I still, for some reason, think the game could be fucking really good one day, just not today. Not this year.
Hopefully. How many more years is it not this year?
Hopefully Squadron they're going to do their release announcement this year at CitizenCon. That's what I'm hoping for.
You want to join the bet?
Yeah,
I bet
trade that they're going to make the announcement and that the release date is 2024. He says they're not going to make the announcement, or if they do, it'll be 2025 and beyond.
I'm not taking any bets because 2014 came and went a long time ago. So
16.
Fast.
Also, for us FPS players, they haven't significantly improved the animations or the feel of
ships.
FPS at all. So
isn't it amazing that they're like, just a couple weeks ago, they did their Inside Star Citizen talking about how they're finally going to make Arena Commander the test bed that it was supposed to be?
10 years ago, yeah.
That cracked me up. Good show.
I'm surprised you watched that content. I haven't watched Star Citizen content in I don't know how long.
Well, you know, I get up at 4 a.m. I work out. I go to work. I come home. I'm fucking exhausted at 5 p.m. I eat and I watch a couple hours worth of YouTube and I go to bed. That's my fucking day every day.
Eat shit, poop.
Well, obviously, right? Wake up, drink coffee, take a shit, work out for about an hour and a half, go to work, tired because I just worked out for an hour and a half, come home at 5 o'clock, burnt, eat. Now I'm fucking super tired, kick my feet up and watch YouTube because I don't have energy for anything else. So
what do you do at the weekends?
Work around the house.
Yes.
Yeah.
Honey-do list.
Today was my day off because I had Thursday, Friday, and Monday, Tuesday. Vacation, so I'm remodeling a bathroom. So today I'm not working. So I thought I'd come and try if I could fuck this show up.
Ah, thanks very much.
You're welcome. Very much.
Mm-hmm. So just skins there it is. And selling some of the ships.
Selling the ships.
Skin, you're still talking about alien ships?
A couple of the armors that they had, the Tiberian armors, are available.
Say what?
The Varian armor. Lucky humans, not here. Watch this. Ships for humans.
People were fascinated by the Sully thumb.
Run.
Yeah. So some people thought this was quite
provocative.
Provocative, yeah. Jeez, I couldn't even say the word.
Why?
The way the gun is.
Oh, please.
It's like a fake God. Dick. Relum scrolled past it. It's so provocative. He scrolled past it twice now. Three times.
Oh, that.
There you go.
I can't leave it on too long. We'll get banned.
Wow. You'll see dicks and everything.
Anibis, that was rude of you to say. I'm going to post a clip of that on YouTube and say you're a dick.
All right, I'll respond.
Let's glue some words together.
We'll get the drama going.
All right, let's get the hell out of here then.
By the way, if you're still interested in the Fury, the Storm, and the Lynx.
Don't be.
In 2 days or something, right?
Yeah, they'd be finished on Monday. So Monday.
Don't give them your money.
Monday noon, UTC. That's usually when they stop.
It's like 12 hours.
Yeah. So it's your last chance to get them.
Don't do it.
LTI tokens.
Oh, LTI tokens, yeah, basically. So, and that's really it.
Okay, good, nice.
Do it now.
Great, we went.
Bye, and
bots. We're going now. Okay, I'll see you next time.
We had
time
to make then. Up from last week since we had to just stop early because of absolute total lack of content.
There was no content this week. You talked about the Hull C, and that's the only thing you talked about. Oh, and the price of
CitizenCon. That's important. Well, hopefully we'll get some good stuff next week too. But until then, goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye.
Next time.
I support the monkeys. Do you?
Gobble.
Check out the base. 24/7 online radio.
Oh yeah.
Visit us at thebase.sc. They're professionals. Jafar!